I pronounce that they are husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
She got Betty Davis eyes.
Anwar Sadat, peacemaker of Egypt, killed in a military assassination.
A country no larger than Wales is torn by civil war and terror.
All anyone can do is watch and wait.
Tonight I'm going to show you something. Make you believe.
The Invisible Terror.
Chris!
Wherever you are, they are.
Someone I really could care for. Then suddenly there appeared
for me the only one. La 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 la, sing a happy song.
Cause I'm the unknown stuntman that made Redford such a star.
Hey folks, Crazy Climber 80 here again, and we're going to look at game number 10 in our 20 from 1981 series, and this is a bit of a Pac-Man knockoff, but it's an excellent Pac-Man knockoff. You're a mouse moving through a maze full of cheese, and you're trying to avoid the cats, and you can turn into a dog and catch them, and this is Mouse Trap by Exidy in 1981. This game was really fun. It had fantastic sound effects, great gameplay. The controls are a little strange. There are three buttons. They are colored buttons. They are red, yellow, and blue, and they will open doors of that color. All the doors of that color will open when you push that button, and you'll want to remember that sequence: red, yellow, blue, RYB, or RIB, however you can remember it. And there's a dog button, and that'll let you change into a dog and turn the tables on the cats. But only after you've eaten a dog biscuit. And there is also a four-way joystick. Now, yeah, I remember this game. I think I first saw it at Malibu Grand Prix back in the day. But boy, was it fun. I still really enjoy it. This has nothing to do with the board game, if you were wondering. The classic board game, Mousetrap. No, I used to own that one, too. But no, this is, like I said, a Pac-Man knockoff. You move through the maze and collect all the cheese, and you are the mouse, little blue mouse. And you move through the maze, and like I said, there's the three doors. Whoops, the computer wasn't very good there. And you see the dog bones in the corners, the dog biscuits. Collect those, collect as many as you can. I mean, it might only show four on the screen at once that you have in your reserve, but I think you can collect more than that. And you press the dog button when you want to change it to a dog, and you only get to change it to the dog for a little while, and then go attack the cats. But as you progress in the game, you'll eventually see the hawk, and the hawk can kill either the mouse or the dog. And to deter the hawk, you want to go into the center where it says in, and that'll make the hawk kind of be stupid for a little bit. Well, let's go ahead and get started. Yeah, you're that little blue mouse, and you move around the maze trying to pick up all the cheese. And there's three different doors that you can open. And they're, again, red, yellow, and blue in that order on the control panel. And it's really important that you remember where they are on the control panel so you can automatically know which button to press. Because later on in the game, the cats are going to get super fast. There is an extra prize you can collect, and that was the big block of cheese. Once you collect that big prize there, then another one will appear somewhere else in the maze. And then we see a paperclip. And the prizes will get to be 200 more than the last. Narrowly avoiding that hawk. And the final prize will be worth 7,200. But the cats will increase with speed as you collect more and more prizes. And note, once you kill a cat, then it will reappear at one of the four edges. Oh man, that was close. And the cat will wander around outside of the maze for a little bit until it stops, and then it's just about to enter the maze. And the music has a few different soundtracks. You will get an extra mouse every 30,000 points. Boy, is this game fun, and it has fantastic music and sound effects. I love the whine of the cats when they get caught by the dog. It's kind of goofy that the hawk has a jungle sound effect. You don't have to enter the in space at the center to deter the hawk. If you're very, very, very nimble, you can still get away from him. But it'll get more and more tenacious as you get further and further in the game. Ah, crap. I love that the game even says, enter in to make the hawk stupid. But when you do enter in, you will be scattered to one of the four corners. And you might land right on a cat. Because the cats can enter that little corner area. And there I just got the last cheese. You will get 10,000 bonus points when you eat all the cheeses in a maze. And I got another extra life at 60,000. But yeah, try to collect as many dog bones as you can. Deft opening of the doors can keep you from having to waste a bone. Oh, I just got into the inn in time. But yeah, you can hold on to reserves of bones if you get more than four, which is all that is shown on the screen. You'll still have more. And if you turn into a dog and are still a dog just before you clear a maze, then you will start the next maze as a dog with whatever power you have left of being a dog. The prizes will continue to get better and better the longer you stay alive, and they will keep increasing as you go to the next mazes. You can wall off the cats if you set up the doors just right. But yeah, you really, really, really want to remember right off the top of your head where the door buttons are, because you will need to quickly open them as the cats get real fast later in the game. You really want to have good controls for this game, because it's easy to accidentally slam into a cat. If you have, like, I didn't press the button in time. If you have a prize lift and a dot, just one last piece of cheese, then see if you can get the prize first. This was a lot of fun. This is probably my best game. I can usually at least get close to 100,000 every time. Crap, yikes. Strangely enough, the Colecovision was the only port, or had the only port of this, where you could face the hawk that I remember. And you had to set it at a certain difficulty level. And that hawk was really one of the key selling points of the game, even though he was pretty annoying. It was definitely something that a port shouldn't be without. And the Atari 2600 version didn't have it, and the Intellivision version didn't have it. This is definitely one of Exidy's best games. Exidy, by the way, stands for Excellence in Dynamics, in case you didn't know that. But when you die, I believe the prizes are restored back to the original, starting with the block of cheese. We'll look at all the prizes later, but they max out at, I think it was 7,200 points for the very last one. I might have mentioned that already. Each piece of cheese is 90 points. It's kind of a weird total. Oh man, look how fast the cats can move now. The more you kill a cat, the faster that cat will become. And so if you kill that same cat many times over and over, then it'll get super fast like that one. Oh, yikes. Holy crap. Yeah, the speed of the cats just gets dizzying late in the game. Ah, crap. Yeah, the hawk can kill either the mouse or the dog. And if you get killed by the cat, or by the hawk, then the game will give you that message, enter in to make the hawk stupid. Buckner and Garcia, who made Pac-Man Fever, and the Pac-Man Fever album, did a song of Mousetrap, and of course had samples from the arcade game in the song. Just love all the sound effects, the dog barking, the cat whining when it's caught, the various crap, I couldn't push the button fast enough. The various goofy sound effects of opening doors, the slurping of the cheese. Just love everything about this game. It was so much fun. Ah, damn! I just could not be fast enough with the dog button. That is Mousetrap by Exidy in 1981. Game number 10 in R20 from 1981 series. Well, I hope you enjoyed my second opening to this series. I'm only going to have it for game number 10. But I hope you're staying cool this summer. Hope you're staying safe, too. Practice social distancing, wear a mask, etc., etc. Well, let's look at the prizes. There's the cheese. Then there's a paperclip. Safety pin. Key. Apple. Trophy. Candlestick. Scissors. Pliers. Glasses. A clock. A bottle. A gem. A bugle. A screw. A hammer. A ring. A light bulb. A needle. A fork. A thimble. A knife. A martini. Fishbone. A pear. A peanut. A die. A phone. Another die. Thread. A teacup. And a gun. Well, that was Mousetrap by Exidy in 1981, game number 10 in our 20 from 1981 series. I thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you soon with game number 9. Y'all have a great summer, and y'all stay cool, stay safe. I will catch you later, folks. Have a good one, everybody. Bye-bye.